Dear friends, we all know Christians are saved by God's grace through faith alone and not by their works, which is proved by several Bible verses like Galatians 2:16 that says, "Know that a person is not justified by the works of the law, but by faith in Jesus Christ." So we too have put our faith in Christ Jesus, that we may be justified by faith in Christ and not by the works of the law, because by the works of the law no one will be justified. And Ephesians 2:8 and 9, which states, "For it is by grace you have been saved through faith, and this is not your own doing. It's a gift of God, not a result of works, so that no one may boast." This means our salvation is free gift from God after Christ's sacrifice on the cross, taking all punishment on our behalf for our sins. This salvation is not because of who we are or what we do, and we don't earn this salvation through our own efforts. At the time of this first phase of our salvation, when we accepted Christ in our hearts genuinely and seriously, we are justified and positioned as righteous and saved from the penalty of sin. After this first step of justification, we go through the second phase of sanctification throughout our life on earth. This sanctification is a process. God knows that our bodies are kind of prone to sin, and every time we repent and confess our sins, God forgives us immediately and declares us holy and righteous. Jesus came for this purpose only. Jesus was both God's Son, John 3:16, and God Himself, God in human flesh, 1 Timothy 3:16. Also like 1 John 1:9 that says, "If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness." There are other verses that say, "God forgets our sins," meaning He will not count those sins at all in our Christian walk. Listen to these verses. Isaiah 43:25 says, "I will not remember your sins." Jeremiah 31:34 also says, "I will forgive their iniquity and I will remember their sin no more." Hebrews 8:12 also reiterates, "For I will be merciful toward their iniquities and I will remember their sins no more." And Hebrews 10:17 also says, "I will remember their sins and their lawless deeds no more." All right, God forgets our sins and declares us righteous every time we get back to Him, and this process continues till our final breath, which is the third phase of our salvation, and that is called glorification, when we are absolutely free from the presence of sin at our death or Christ's second coming. Well, at the first step of our salvation, we are justified and positioned righteous by God's grace through faith alone and not by our own works, we all know. Now the question is, during the second phase of sanctification, which we are undergoing right now, do we please God and get His acceptance and favor by doing works like fasting, praying, giving to charity, attending church meetings, and doing other Christian activities? What does the Bible say? Let's examine this most important disputed doctrine. Galatians 3:2 and 3 says, "Did you receive the Spirit by the works of the law or by believing what you heard? Are you so foolish? After beginning by means of the Spirit, are you now trying to finish by means of the flesh?" The Galatians began their relationship with God by believing in Jesus and receiving the Holy Spirit by grace alone. But at some point along the way, they started thinking they needed to add works to their faith in order to be saved and to continue receiving God's blessing and favor in their lives. Like the Galatians, as time goes on, we also kind of tend to think that our spiritual performance determines God's love and blessings for us. For the Galatians, this meant trying to earn God's blessing through works of the law, like being circumcised, observing special days, and keeping the Jewish food laws. Today, we tend to think, the more I read my Bible, the more I pray, the more I give, the more active I am in church, the more God loves me, the more He is pleased with me, the more He will bless me, watch over me, protect me, and prosper me, and ultimately save me. This system of performance basically says the degree of God's blessing towards us is based on the degree of our spiritual achievement. No, just rethink about this attitude we have. Paul points out to the Galatians, this way of thinking is completely false. It's not gospel. In fact, it's anti-gospel. our works, our efforts, our spiritual performance can never earn God blessings. Why? Because God's standards are too high for us to ever achieve. We might be holier than the other people we know, but compared to God, we have not accomplished anything. Trying to earn God's blessing, favor, and salvation is a road that leads to a dead end. In our heart of hearts, we know this already. I might think I am more blessed by God when I do more for Him, but deep down I know I am not doing nearly enough. I am not praying as much as I should. I am not reading the Bible as much as I should. And I am not witnessing, giving, or sacrificing as much as I should. I feel God is probably kind of disappointed with me and maybe even angry with me. So I feel guilty. I do not see things improving in my life. So I may put on a happy face and pretend everything is fine when I go to church, but I know what I am from my inside. Thankfully, there's a better way. There is a good news. There is the way of grace, as Paul points out to the Galatians. Grace says God's blessing, favor, and salvation were not based on my own efforts in the first place. And so God's continued blessing, favor, and salvation are not based on my efforts going forward either. Instead, it's based on the finished work of Jesus on my behalf, which I receive by faith alone. Galatians 3:9 says, "So then, those who are of faith are blessed along with Abraham, the man of faith." Okay, God's love for me is not based on what I do. It's based on what Jesus has already done for me. Of course, there are many things I need to do. Read the Bible, pray, give, serve, share about Jesus with those who do not know Him. But there is a world of difference between doing these things out of the blessing and favor I have received from God through Jesus, as opposed to doing these things in order to earn God's blessing and favor. This is the difference between grace and law, gospel and anti-gospel, freedom and bondage, life and death. The process of salvation is by grace alone, through faith alone, in Christ alone. This is the gospel. This is why it's good news. Now listen to these facts too. Our salvation is secure. The security of salvation of a believer is the core doctrine of the Bible. There are hundreds of verses that support this doctrine in one way or another. The concept of losing one's salvation is flawed in so many ways. At what point would your person lose it? How much sin is too much? Where would you cross the saved, unsaved line? The idea of losing our salvation is not only unscriptural, but it creates monumental problems with other doctrines, including salvation by faith, the very nature of man to sin, and the purpose of Christ's sacrifice. If eternal security is not true, no one has ever been saved, because we all are sinful by nature. You believe in Christ today and have eternal life, but lose it tomorrow. It was never eternal at all. Please listen to these verses which emphasize our salvation is secure. For all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Romans 3:23. Therefore, there is no condemnation now for those who are in Christ Jesus. Romans 8:1. For I am convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither the present nor the future, nor any powers, neither height nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Romans 8:38 and 39. For God's gifts and call are irrevocable. Romans 11:29. And who has also put His seal on us and given us the Spirit in our hearts as a guarantee. 2 Corinthians 1:22. But if it's by grace, it's no longer on the basis of works. Otherwise, grace would no longer be grace. Romans 11:6. Who will sustain you to the end, guiltless, on the day of our Lord Jesus Christ? 1 Corinthians 1:8. Well, you heard it all. Proven facts through Bible verses I already quoted. Here's the gist of all we learnt. We are justified, righteous, at the beginning of our salvation that starts at the time of our accepting Jesus in our hearts. Then the process of sanctification goes on till our death. During this process, we are prone to sin. Let me explain. If a son rebels against his father, his relationship with his father is affected, but still he remains to be his son always. Son's relationship with his dad is restored when he repents and gets back to his dad, who forgives him, accepts him every time and all the time because he is his son. The same way, we are always God's children and our salvation is not affected. And every time we repent and confess our sins, God forgives and forgets our sins. This process of salvation is by God's grace alone and through our faith alone and not at all through our good works. We do good works automatically while living as Christians out of thankfulness to God, though these good Christian works are not the condition to earn God's favor, love, and acceptance. We remain His children always till our final breath or Christ's second coming, and we attain glorification and become sinless thereafter.